happy to speak with you at this time, at this moment. Yeah, today I'm going to be talking about how I bagged 3 qualification cards from 3 London best universities in just 2 years. For the first time, my name is Charity Ubia. I'm originally from Nigeria. I just finished my master's degree from the University of East London and also PGCE from the University of London and advanced diploma from Inspire London College. For my subscribers, thank you for stopping by today. For new subscribers or new people watching me this at this moment, please ensure that you hit the notification button and subscribe. Yeah, help a sister to grow, because when you're going to grow together. Yeah, good. So today I'm going to be talking about, like I said before, how I packed 3 qualifications. Yeah, it sounds like, can that really be possible? How can somebody study from 3 universities in just 2 years and back 3 degrees? Yes, it's very possible. I thought as much as well when I wanted to start. I had this full of fear that, well, literally I just started my MBA, so I'm not gonna cope with another degree. I never knew that there's another one even behind or coming. Yeah, I left Nigeria, my home country, in 2019 for my master's degree in business administration. I never had any clue of how, of my journey, of my future in the United Kingdom. I only came for master's degree. So arriving here, I did my first term, and I quite like enjoy the environment, even though it was a bit hard for me to integrate as coming from African country, which obviously the UK education is different from ours and the way they do things. So I try as much as possible to ensure that I integrate in and also mingle as much and as fast as I could. Yeah, I finished my first term, had good results. I had parallel A's in my first term. I was like feeling, oh good, thank you God. That means, Charity, you are gonna get it. So, while I was studying, I used to apply for various positions. Of course, I would want to have some part-time job to support me in my feeding and my expenses in the UK, because it could be quite expensive to live and study in London. I applied for jobs, I constantly got rejections, and I noticed that the competition is quite high for international students like me to integrate into the system. And for me to meet up the competition, I have to ensure that I get the UK degree and also get the UK experience, in quote. Yeah, it was tough, but okay. Since I applied for jobs in the first 3 months, I didn't really have any good job. So I told myself I'm not gonna do any menial job that I can't add to my CV. Like, I've already strategized how my future will look like and the route I should take to ensure that it lands me at where I want to be. So doing menial jobs to make both ends meet was not necessarily an option for me. Not that I'm looking down on those jobs, but at least I had some money that could sustain me. So I constantly looked for jobs that I can transfer the skills I'm gonna learn there into my next role. Based on my research and also from the words of mouth from trusted individuals, no doubt, I noticed that the teaching industry, the educational industry, is quite lucrative in the UK, and it is possible, or it is a bit easy for me to be accepted into the system if I have the qualification. Luckily for me, I got a job in a teaching role in one of the high schools here in London, teaching assistants. So I started that job that was around April 2019. I started working part-time as teaching assistant. I worked there for like 2 months, and I knew that I was suddenly developing this passion, interest in education. I researched, okay, how am I gonna get into this teaching profession as well, maybe to match up, though I have communication background, I need to have a UK teaching qualification to allow me to teach in the United Kingdom. I had difficulty in terms of the tuition fees. Well, we'll talk about that in the next video, how I overcame that. So I decided to enroll at the University of London after doing so many, lot of research, considering so many higher education that could have the best teaching profession or teaching qualifications that would suit me. Finally, I got settled with the University of London. The reason I got settled was that they had this goodies in terms of graduating from that university, you would be recognized as a worldwide recognized tutor anywhere in the world. You cannot just teach in the United Kingdom, you can teach anywhere in the world. So that really attracted me to doing the program at the University of London, because I was like, wow, it's opening this door for me to become a global asset. Okay, excellent, then I'll go for it. Another thing was that the tuition fee was quite high, but I did not mind that. I knew that God has money. Yeah, applied for admission. It was a bit hard for me to get admission, get admitted into the degree, because they needed someone who is actively lecturing in the university or in colleges. No, I left Nigeria. I wasn't teaching in Nigeria, but I did some part-time teachings while I was there, and also running my own company. So I reached out to a few of the individuals in Nigeria where I had some part-time teachings in that school to give me recommendation letter. So I was lucky they were able to reference me, and I sent that across to the University of London. Yeah, at the end I was accepted. Good. I started that was August 2019, got enrolled fully to start my second master's degree. It was quite hard for me to combine PGCE with my MBA. At that time, I had finished first and second term of my MBA at the University of East London. So that period where we were doing, where we were on holidays, I used that to study for or to commence my master's degree at the University of London. It was quite challenging for me to combine both, but what I did was that I tried to ensure that I managed my time wisely. I prioritized my workload, which one to be done first and which is to be done second. I ensure that when I started the MBA, the third term for my MBA, that I tried to do my assignment early, because typically it comprises 4 months to make a term in a UK university. So the first 3 months would be teaching, then the remaining 1 month would be for you to do your assignment and coursework and submit. And one thing that is good about the UK university is that they discuss their assignments upfront. Like the beginning of that term, they would discuss with you the learning outcome, what you expected to learn in that module, and what is expected from you to pass the module. And they will discuss what we call assignment brief at the first day of the term or the starting of the term. So what I did that helped me to be able to manage my master's at the University of London and MBA at the University of East London, ensure that I do my assignment ahead of time. I try to do research on my own, go to classes, and ensure that I do my assignment before the deadline. So luckily for me, I was able to finish my assignment within the first 2.5 months of the term. So the remaining 2 months, I would be using it to, I would be focusing on my second master's degree. Don't get me wrong, it wasn't that easy as I'm saying, but it was doable. And I did it. and it yielded good results. At the University of London, I opted in for distance learning because it wasn't easy for me to attend classes in both physical classes, because I really needed to be physically present at the University of East London, who sponsored my visa to be here in the UK. So I make sure that I attended classes, tap in, my attendance was 100%. But for the University of London, I opted in for distance learning, where I studied online using the virtual learning environment. And how my attendance were tracked on that particular University of London was surprising. For me to pass one stage in terms of, for example, the topic for the week, if I do not finish the topic for the week, it will not show that I'm progressing. But you would see how your colleagues are actually progressing in the studies. So if you don't finish one module and write about 1,000 words in each of the topics for you to progress to the next topic, your attendance will be marked less. And imagine writing 1,000 words for every week, and to ensure that I marked my attendance and to show that I have studied that particular topic for that week. It was tedious. And attending MBA degree as well at the University of East London. All the same, I prioritized my work. I did my assignment from the University of East London up front. I used the remaining time to do my real-time assessment and attendance tracking at the University of London for my master's degree in learning and teaching in higher education. Yeah, I progressed steadily as I was able to prioritize and ensure that I managed my time well. Progressing steadily was a good one. I still had my prelates in the first, in my MBA. Then when the result of my assignment at the University of London was announced, I saw that I did pretty well. I was like, okay, thank God I'm able to do that. That means this journey is doable. Yeah, I trusted the process. Then I still move ahead, combining the two. December 2019, in my MBA, I did that particular term, I did a module called Marketing in the Digital Age. And that led me to like having interest in digital marketing, and I scored really high in that particular module. I was like, wow, this is amazing. Maybe this is my strength too. Probably I can, because I was wondering when I was doing my master's at postgraduate certificate in learning and teaching, was like asking myself, what I'm going to be teaching? Okay, I'm going to be teaching business. I'm going to be teaching, business modules. Yeah. But now I've found a new passion. I've discovered a new passion in digital marketing. And the best part of it was that it related to what I was doing in Nigeria, my first degree, which was in communication. I saw it to be another passion, another career to develop. Yeah. So I decided to make more research on digital marketing. And again, digital marketing is evolving in the United Kingdom, is emerging. And digital marketers, or marketeers as the case might be, are really getting high salary. Of course, I wanted to go, or I always want a particular industry that is booming, that is evolving, that I can have my leg on there. Yeah, I did. the placement was just there. I did nothing. So I made use of that full 1 year. 2020 August, I completed my master's degree in learning and teaching from the University of London. That was for 1 year. I wrote my dissertation, and then I continued. I had enough time then to continue studying for my advanced diploma in digital marketing. In that one, I finished towards the end of 2020. Towards the end of 2020, that was when I rounded up my advanced diploma at the Inspire London College. I took my final exams and I passed with flying colors. Before now, my placement has come to an end. So, you can see the entire COVID-19 pandemic, I was literally studying at home. And it was a blessing for me in disguise. So literally, I wasn't wasting my time grumbling about COVID-19. I was using the time to study while also working part-time at the University of East London. I rounded up the two programs within 2020. Late 2020, I have finished my placements and then moved into writing my thesis. And I did that, I completed that within 2 months. I used 2 months to finish my thesis. From November to December, I had already finished my thesis because I needed to graduate in January 2021 for my Master's in Business Administration, MBA, from the University of East London. Remember, I had completed a PGCE from the University of London and Advanced Diploma from Inspire London College in 2020, December. So in January 2021, I was able to submit, hand in my thesis for MBA, which I scored an A. In it, I scored a distinction. And overall, in my MBA, I had a distinction, which you all knew about. I felt so fulfilled that I was able to manage my time in studying for these three qualifications and still achieve so much good grades, especially from my MBA that brought me to the United Kingdom, achieved highly, and also doing other extracurricular activities to boost my career. So my take home word for you is that you can do everything. You never can tell how the kind of strength you have if you decide to do a particular thing. But what helped me to achieve this three qualifications in just 2 years was time management. I knew how to prioritize my time. I had minus zero social life because there was no time for social life. All my time was literally around library, studying at home during the COVID. And also I was intentional about my career path. I knew where I was going to. I knew what I needed to do now to ensure that it lands me at where I needed to be career-wise. So I was intentionally focused. I knew what I was doing. And the last thing you need to go home with is determination. I was determined to make it work. And with God, it worked out. And today, I can gladly say I studied in three universities into the glory of God. I hope, guys, you enjoy my little story. And yeah, in our next video, I'm going to be discussing with you how I've been able to use a scholarship to gain all this. So I'm sorry that I keep my story boring, but at least you end of my story, my journey from leaving Nigeria to studying in the United Kingdom and to graduation in 2 years. I believe with this story, it has encouraged you to keep the hard work you are doing, to be intentionally focused, to be determined, and to manage your time properly. Because time waits for no man. That's the end of my video, guys. Thank you very much for staying to the end of the video. And do have a very lovely day ahead. Do not forget to subscribe, hit the notification button so I will be bringing, you'll be notified when I bring any valuable contents your way. Thank you very much and have a lovely one. Goodbye.